Today we'll solve one more question of accounting equation. So this is the question right here. Number one, Cummins business with cash rupees 1,75,000. Purchase goods on from Rohit rupees 50,000. That means this is credit purchase. Purchase made from Rohit means purchase is on credit basis. Next is sold goods on credit to Manish costing rupees 17,500 at for rupees 20,000. So we have sold goods on credit to Manish. The cost of the goods were rupees 17,500, but we have sold it for rupees 20,000. Next is purchase furniture for office use rupees 10,000. Next is cash paid to Rohit in full settlement. Next is cash received from Manish rupees 20,000. Rent paid rupees 1,000 and outstanding rupees 2,000. Goods destroyed by fire rupees 10,000 and cash withdrawn for personal use rupees 5,000. So this is all that we need to do. So let us start preparing an accounting equation. The format is well known to all of you. So I am showing you right here. Please check it. I have solved the sum already. This is the solved question. You might be able to see here. The full question is solved. Now let us see one by one. Number one, started business with cash. Commencement started. Commenced business with cash rupees 1,75,000. So cash and capital 1,75,000. Here we need to make 7 columns. Cash, stock, debtors, furniture, capital, creditors and rent outstanding. Next is purchase goods from Rohit. So we have purchased goods from Rohit 50,000 in stock and 50,000 in creditors. Next is sold goods to Manish on credit. So we'll sell goods to Manish on credit. So stock will be lost. Stock will be gone. So we'll deduct stock rupees 17,500. And we have sold these goods for rupees 20,000. But we have sold it on credit basis, so no effect on cash column. We'll get rupees 20,000 from the debtors. Instead of Manish, I have written debtors because Manish is our debtor. And instead